The unemployment insurance boost of $600 per week has helped millions and millions of people avoid what would otherwise be incredibly devastating circumstances. But here's the bad news. On July 31st, that extra $600 per week in unemployment insurance is set to expire. Congress is in session right now working on a brand new stimulus bill, but the question remains, will the unemployment insurance boost be extended past the July 31st deadline? In this video, I'm going to tell you some really interesting information that I happened to find out, which is going to answer that question. Now, I know this is pretty crazy, but I happen to know some people that know some people in Washington, and they have said with certainty that the unemployment insurance boost will be extended. I'm going to tell you the details of that in this video, so be sure to stick around. My name is Kevin Conway. I'm a lawyer from California, and I make personal finance videos and stimulus news update videos all the time. So if you want to stay informed, be sure to subscribe to the channel, and please give a quick like to this video and share it with whoever you think it might benefit. Now let's get right into it. So like I said, I'm a lawyer, but I actually do real estate development full time. We're constantly in interaction with the most sophisticated capital markets teams in the entire country, meaning the people that actually provide us debt and equity for our real estate projects. We're in constant communication with those firms. Each year, we borrow hundreds and hundreds of millions of dollars from these firms in order to buy the apartments that we buy in the Western United States. Now, I know what you're saying. What does this have to do with the stimulus? And I'm gonna tell you. Because we have such close relationships with these firms, we often want to know what their head economists in their firms are actually thinking about the economy in real time. They have people themselves who only focus on what the economy is gonna look like 3 months from now, 6 months from now, 12 months from now. They are in the cutting edge and understanding exactly what the economy is going to do. These firms spend millions and millions of dollars to be in the right place at the right time and get the right data in order to inform judgments. And we just so happen to be lucky enough to be in contact with some of these firms. And I was on the phone the other day with one of the people, I'm not gonna mention who, I'm not gonna mention from where, from one of these firms, really, really sophisticated type of firms. And he told me that they have lobbyists and other people working in DC, rubbing elbows with the right people and understanding the actual policy moves that are being developed now, which are telling them with certainty that the unemployment insurance boost of $600 per week is going to be extended past July 31st, with a few caveats. So this is what the person told me. A couple weeks ago, it was 50-50 whether or not the unemployment insurance would actually be extended past the July 31st timeline. That was a few weeks ago when the economy was doing a little bit better and politicians really didn't see a big enough reason to extend this incredible program. But in recent weeks, as cases have surged, as the economy has begun to shut down again once more, the impetus to actually pass another bill, to pass a bill that includes the extension of the unemployment insurance, has only grown, and now it is a near certainty. Those are his words, and that comes directly from the people in Washington, D.C. Another thing this person told me is that they don't actually know how long the unemployment insurance benefits will be extended for. That's still being hashed out for right now. But one thing can be gleaned from the political environment, and that is that we think that this unemployment insurance boost will be extended to at least past the November election. And why? Because politicians are gonna be out of DC, they're gonna be campaigning again, and they're gonna want to get re-elected. And they don't wanna deal with this bill another time before the elections come along. So more or less, we can understand that this unemployment insurance in some form will probably be extended past the election. And again, that comes from the context that we have in Washington, D.C. right now, who are talking with the politicians actually writing this bill. And let me just interject and say, I know how ridiculous this is, almost cronyistic, how that you have to know a certain person who knows a person in D.C. in order to understand what a bill might look like when it passes. But that unfortunately is the state of our politics right now. I'm just trying to bring you the information that I know, that I found out just by happenstance through my job. Now, getting back to it, how much is the unemployment insurance going to be? What dollar amount is actually going to be attached? Is it going to be that $600 or is it going to be something else? And here is more or less what is being talked about in DC with relative certainty. And it is that that extra couple hundred dollar boost will remain intact. That core component of the unemployment insurance will remain intact, but it likely will be sized to whatever you were making before you lost your job. It'll be limited to some factor, including what you made from before your job, so as not to discourage people from going back to work because they're making more on unemployment. That's at least the reasoning behind it. That's what's going to get the people on the other side of the aisle to come together and pass this bill. But the key component is that boost on top of what your state unemployment is paying you. Remember, because your state also pays you that unemployment insurance, which goes on for 13 weeks longer than whatever your state had before, which is about 39 weeks in most states, and it was roughly about $400 to $500 per week per state. Now, it's on top of that amount. The federal boost is going to be on top of that amount. We know that it'll be at least a couple hundred dollars on top of that state amount. And here's another really important thing that this person at the firm told me, that their economist who was in DC told him. And they said that people on Capitol Hill right now are saying, look, it may not be the best program there is. It may not be exactly the program that I support politically, that is the unemployment insurance, but here's a simple fact of the matter. If we do not extend the unemployment insurance boost of at least a couple hundred dollars per week, one thing is for certain, and that is millions of more people will be unemployed, the economy will do significantly worse, and not passing this is going to completely undo huge portions of what has already been done in the previous stimulus bills. Everything from Federal Reserve cutting interest rates to zero, to passing the CARES Act, and everything in between. All of that could be undone by not passing the extended unemployment insurance benefits past July 31st. That is directly from what my friend at that firm told me that the people in DC told him. And I think it holds a lot of weight. And there also remains one crucially important and frankly somewhat cynical point to this entire ordeal. And that is that those who write the rules, those in government, those in Congress right now, have a lot to actually lose if this unemployment insurance isn't extended. And what I mean by that is, if the unemployment insurance isn't extended, economists from across the political spectrum have all said that the economy could fare much worse. Every business could be affected. Real estate values could drop dramatically. And those in Congress, well, they have assets, they have stocks, they own real estate, and they stand to lose something by not actually extending this unemployment insurance benefit. At least that's what a lot of people seem to think, and I am almost certain that the unemployment insurance will be extended based upon that reason alone. Maybe that's just a tad too cynical. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. So there you have it. That is news that you probably are not going to read online anywhere because it is closely guarded information. Of course, a lot of people stand to make a lot of money if they know something like this. And that is pretty sad that the public, by and large, is kept out of the loop, of developments politically right now that means so much to so many people. But I'm just trying to hear, bring it to you guys, tell you exactly what I know from my research and from what I do full time. It just so happened to relate exactly to what I'm doing here on YouTube. So there you really have it. I think that you are going to see that extension of unemployment insurance benefits, but it may be capped to whatever you're making before the loss of your job. Now, that may not actually come to fruition. It may be too hard to administer, but I think that probably is going to be at least tailored in some way to push a lot of the people who wouldn't normally vote for that bill on to voting for the bill once more. And I also think that you might see additional things in this stimulus package, such as additional stimulus checks and additional things like payroll tax cuts, which is something President Trump has been in favor of doing. But one thing we know is that the unemployment insurance has a very, very high likelihood of passing again. And what happens if the unemployment insurance isn't passed again? What happens if it actually ends on July 31st? Well, I think we could be in a whole lot of trouble. Check out my previous video. I go into detail, I bring up some statistics and quotes from different economists and studies that I've read that actually detail right, left, and center what people think will happen if this one piece of legislation is not passed again. It is not good news. It is not good news if you're on unemployment insurance or even if you still have your job. So what do you guys think of this new development and what do you think is the best solution to happen? Do you think it's a good idea to extend this unemployment insurance? Most people in my previous videos have certainly stated yes, but some people had some interesting reasons why they don't think it should be extended. Please let me know in the comments below. And again, please remember, stay safe. Like the video if it helped you out and subscribe to the channel if you want to stay informed. I'll see you next time. Thanks.